Hi, my name's Jeffrey Meyerhard. I'm a gastrointestinal medical oncologist at the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute in Boston, Massachusetts. I serve as the clinical director of the Gastrointestinal Cancer Center and the deputy clinical research officer of the Dana-Farber. Colon and rectal cancer is the fourth most common cancer diagnosed in the United States. It is probably also the most preventable cancer. We know that we can prevent colon cancer and improve mortality through screening. Those guidelines include checking stool for blood that can't be seen. It includes doing a sigmoidoscopy or a full colonoscopy, which looks at your entire colon. The most effective screening is a colonoscopy. Most patients who are diagnosed with colon and rectal cancer don't have symptoms, but there are certain signs and symptoms that you should alert your primary care physician or other providers. Those would include bleeding in the stool, abdominal bloating, unexpected weight loss, and if you have blood tests and you're found to be anemic, those are reasons to screen for colon and rectal cancer. If you have these symptoms, it does not mean you have colon or rectal cancer, but it is a reason to alert your physician to be able to look further into your symptoms. Current guidelines suggest patients to start screening at age 50 unless they have certain risk factors. Those would include having a family history, particularly people who have younger family members who were diagnosed with colon cancer, or having a colon or rectal polyp, or having certain diseases like ulcerative colitis or Crohn's disease. The American Cancer Society recently came out with guidelines to suggest that screening should actually start at age 45. The risk is still very low in those under 50, but it is relatively increasing compared to where it was several decades ago.